Howdy ding dong doodly guys, welcome back to Let's Play Danganronpa 2. Did I say Trigger Happy Havoc last time? I think I did, you know. Oh, I'm just remembering now, but anyway, welcome back to Let's Play Danganronpa 2. Goodbye Despair. With me, TapersCrazy. Well, let's lift off. We continue introducing ourselves to characters that explored around a bit, and today we're going to continue on with actually, it's going to take a long time by the looks, but I'm curious of why there's a Monokuma machine here. Looks like a vending machine, but doesn't seem to accept money. Do I have to use some type of coin? Monocoins, probably. It's one big cola bottle. I better go flat before I could even finish drinking it. Yeah, that's what I don't get about big cola bottles. You'll have like a family 15 to get through a bottle before it goes flat. Okay, we've got a camera. Yeah. Has it actually been explained why we're being monitored? It's a surfboard. Being said, I might even move for water sports. I'll move a monitor up there. So I thought a blank screen. Okay, so I guess now we shall speak to. God, make such a horrendous noise. We shall speak to this. Excuse me.
Hello.
Oh, hi. Who are you? I'm Hajime Hinata.
Hello.
Your attention is super low. Are you feeling alright?
Oh!
Oh, that's right. Introductions are a go-go!
Ibuki Mio Da! Put it together and what do you get? Ibuki Mio Da!
I assume that's your name. She's a very loud, isn't she? Ultimate musician. Makes perfect sense.
Alright, introductions are finished. More importantly, check out this bombastic supermarket.
I see, I see.
They call me Mr. Bombastic, Jelly Fantastic, then I read it romantic.
Wait, what? Wait, who's I don't even know the words.
They got hamburgers, ramen noodles, chili beans, bratwurst, pasta. Ooh, melons.
No problemo.
Americans, Chinese, Mexicans, Germans, Italians, and different people from your body would shop here.
What's that nose? What?
Man, I'm getting hella stoked! I'm 41 flavors of stoked for all this deliciousness! Come on, I'm excited! I get hungry-mungry! I don't understand it myself. I don't get hungry when I'm excited. I don't get excited when I'm hungry. The human body sure is a mystery.
This energetic young lady is known as the ultimate musician. She used to play guitar in an old girl band and was super popular with other high school girls. One of her hit single, After School Poyoyon, however, sold over a million copies. A super popular all-girl high school band. Sounds familiar.
What?
Due to creative differences, she left her band to pursue a solo career. Creative differences.
Oh my my!
Are you interested?
What? You could hear me.
Duh, Ibuki's a musician. Ibuki's a musician after all.
Guitar!
Like Schubert, Bach, Edison, Van Gogh, Paris, and Senna, I too am an awesome musician.
Oh, so you're saying you have good hearing. Did she say Van Gogh?
Wait, most of the people you mentioned weren't musicians at all.
Don't sift details.
I got a feeling I'm going to like this one very much.
I see.
There's cappuccino, Darjeeling tea, K tea, green tea, yerba tea, ooh, Uda. French, British, Turkish, Japanese, Argentines, even people from Kagawa Prefecture would shop here.
Why was that last one a food?
Pointing.
What do you mean? Udon is a drink.
That's definitely not true. I love Ibuki. Man. Okay, let's get out of this godforsaken place. And go see who also got to hang around with. There was another place, wasn't there, that we needed to go visit? An airport. Why don't we just take a plane? And, you know, leave this place. Okay. Nice to see the island actually does have an airport, though.
Hello.
This is an airport, right? So, those things over there must be garden sheds! Airplanes! Gonna use those planes to escape this island.
Nah, that's impossible. They're damaged, I can fix them. Looks like these planes are just for show.
Just for show.
Man.
The engine's been completely removed. Nothing I kinda knew about that.
Completely removed? Whoever brought us to this island must have also done that, right? The same person who's controlling that stuffed animal, Usami. But who is doing this? And why did they bring us to this island in the first place? And how did they do it? The more I think about it, the less sense it makes.
That's right!
Oh yeah, that reminds me. You haven't been introduced yet, right?
Name's Kazuichi Soda. I'm the ultimate mechanic. Nice to meet ya.
Nice to meet you too, I guess. You have very sharp teeth. Yeah, my ultimate mechanic makes sense.
As expected from someone called the ultimate mechanic, Kazuichi is a savant when it comes to fixing machines. He says it's impossible to fix his plane, it's truly beyond repair.
Hey.
Even so, to actually remove the engine, whoever's keeping us here must have planned this to a T.
You think so too, huh? Doesn't this seem pretty strange to you?
That was close.
Yeah, it's pretty strange. But not having an acceptable level of strange, you know?
Huh?
I mean...
Well, think about it. It's not like we're being forced to do something dangerous or anything. Well, it's mentioning the safety precautions of his school trip. Remember the school trip guidelines written in the e-handbook? Yeah.
Extreme violence is prohibited on this island. Please live peaceful and relaxing lives with your fellow students. Be considerate of each other and work together to obtain hope fragments. Littering is not allowed. Let us coexist with this island's bountiful nature in mutual prosperity. The lead teacher cannot directly interfere with the students. An exception to this rule is made if any student violates a rule.
They all make sense.
For now.
Looks like we're being kept safe, so why doesn't this be like any other school trip? There's nothing dangerous on this island. It's maybe it's peaceful, relaxing days nourishing hope. Just as Usami said earlier. Seems these rules are in place to help us do that. I was saying you believe what that thing told us. She forced us to come here, you know.
What?
I'm such a pessimist. Should live the situation with a bit more hope, you know. Optimism is essential for people to live satisfied lives.
That's right.
Well, it's okay if we just enjoy a vacation and see how this whole thing plays out, right? We stay close to a strange looking bunny girl. She might start looking pretty cute.
I'm actually jealous of how carefree he's being right now.
We don't have time to be carefree.
Hey.
Okay. I can't feel like that though. I mean, it's telling me to not be pessimistic when we're trapped on an island.
Which one's mine?
Pineapple! Why is there a pineapple? Okay, is that everything around here? This is like just the average airport. What about this guy?
Fiend. Stop right there. If you value your life, do not come any closer.
Huh?
Fine.
I said stay back. Oh, very well. Just accept that courage of yours.
Ooh, what's this guy talking about?
Would you like to know my name? Others may see your courage as recklessness. However, I welcome it.
Listen well.
In honor of your courage, shall reveal to you courage. Shall reveal to you my name. May you never forget it for as long as you live.
You may call me Gundam Tanaka. Remember it well, for it is the name that will one day rule this world.
Okay. Ultimate Breeder. Not what I had in mind. Rule this world. He's kidding, right? He's actually serious, that's pretty out there.
Let me ask.
Now then, it is my turn to ask questions. Whose master are you?
Eh?
You!
Which tribe did you make your pact with? Answer me!
What do you mean pact?
Burn in the fires of pandemonium!
Answer me now! Though I shall cast you into a watery grave once you do.
Then it's best if I don't answer.
Perhaps?
I think he's asking if he used to have a pet.
Pet? No. The only animal I've ever taken care of was a hermit crab we passed around in elementary school.
Impossible.
So, a mere insect.
Taste your powerlessness.
Ha! Your magic essence caps at a lowly 5. Trash.
To trash? Really?
Kneel.
It is wrong to call trash trash. Trash like you should not dare to speak to one as grand as me.
My name is Gundam Tanaka.
Who do you think I am? I am a great and powerful Gundam Tanaka.
Supreme Overlord of Ice.
Hold on a minute. Something strange just came out of your scarf.
This is the Tanaka Empire!
Taming evil by using myself as a bed. Truly, this is the secret art of a Tanaka Empire.
It's like something you'd see on a nature show. She told if it's a Bill of Ultimate Reader.
One of my four dark devils of destruction. Mirage, Golden Hog, Jumpy has this to say. We're not used to going easy on our enemies. So don't make us angry. You wouldn't like us when we're angry.
Especially that big one on the right, man. I guess I should let him do that. It's different eye glows as well.
Yeah. I know he seems a lot, but apparently he did splendidly as a member of a breeding club. Already can't save many an animal. Even managed to succeed at proliferating an endangered species. Rumor has it, can speak to animals. It's probably just a joke.
Speak of animals, well, it's certainly eccentric enough in that regard. I mean, there's no way an old person would attempt to raise hamsters inside their own scarf. Oh, have I met everyone? Was that a school bell just now?
Huh?
Hajime, look at the monitor over there.
Oh, drink some cola.
Congratulations, everyone! It appears that everyone has finished collecting the hope fragments.
Indeed, I guess.
I'm so happy!
Okay.
So, I've prepared a present for everyone that'll make you all very happy.
It best not involve a killing game.
I apologize for the trouble, but please gather at the beach. May shining hope be with you all.
God, you have such a hope boner, don't you?
We must all fulfill hope.
She sends me to the beach.
Is that going to be okay? I'm starting to have a bad feeling about this.
What? Thinking won't solve anything. Kind of after we go to the beach.
Is that precaution really enough? To be honest, I'm really worried. It would look bad if I was the other one who didn't go. Well, I assume everyone else would go as well. Well, actually, it's kind of odd of some, like, I'm not sure if Takami would go. Then again, you're probably interested to know what's going on. Right, shift my cup, sorry. Okay, so let's go to the beach, which is this it? Okay. Well, at least we got around everywhere, didn't we? Oh God!
Such ignorance!
You guys are the last to arrive. What are you dilly-dallying for?
Sorry to keep you waiting.
That's fine.
Well, it's all right. More importantly, this is the only chance to talk between ourselves before that rabbit returns.
Let's talk.
Listen.
Now then, let me hear your initial impressions of this island.
Now that you mention it.
I happen to notice numerous blocked off bridges on the central island.
Oh!
Professor, so everybody doesn't get lost! I tried to quick cross one of them, but Rabbit showed up and told me so. Tell him the truth!
What?
So we don't get lost. Is this island really so big?
We've learned in depth. There's no island, right? It's got a resort and everything. Well, I would never been to a resort before, but.
Hey!
Also, there's a big ranch!
There's also a large supermarket, too. Looks like it stocks everything from food to living amenities.
The hotel was really nice, too. It'd be great if we can stay there. The restaurant inside the hotel was also very nice. Seems to cater to a more plebeian taste.
Hey.
Can you guys listen to what I want to say, too? I found something very important on this island. Girls. Very, very cute girls. All over the place.
Gross! I'm getting goosebumps.
All of you are fools. Can't believe nobody has mentioned the most serious truth.
Huh? Most serious truth?
Not possible.
If none here realized it, you're bigger fools than I thought.
Huh?
What'd you say, you fat bastard? I'm talking all big and shit.
Such ignorance.
Small dog shouldn't bark so loud. Most serious truth? What does it mean? Hey, what do you mean, Byakuya? Hey, what's the most serious truth? Did you find something about this island? Have you all gone to the park that's across the bridge? The park with that wee bronze statue of all those creepy animals, right?
Listen.
When I saw it, I remembered a story I heard before.
There's an island in the Pacific Ocean, a beautiful island paradise where summer never ends. It consists of a central island surrounded by five different islands. It's also said that five holy animals symbolize each of those surrounding islands.
Eh?
Listen.
That island's name is Jabberwock Island.
Could it be?
Could this island be Jabberwock Island? Is that the name of this island?
Very strange.
Still, there is something on my mind. In fact, according to what I've heard, Jabberwock Island is already... Never mind.
Hold on!
Hold it right there! It's a rather incomplete story you've told us.
Don't worry.
No need to shout. I'll let you know once I obtain more information.
Meh. I don't care if this island's cold. Nico Nico Island or Papua Island or whatever. Doesn't change the fact we're all gonna live here, right?
Yahoo!
Living together with Tropical I'm sure is exciting. I'm sure looking forward to it.
Right on. This ain't a bad school at all. Hey, you guys.
I like it.
I like this island too.
Yeah.
Can't say the same about the rest, you cretins.
Did I hear something? Did she just call us cretins?
I'm still worried, but I don't feel as worried as I did earlier. Yes, this is no danger or inconvenience. I feel like this won't be a problem.
Hey, listen to what you guys are saying. We need to stay calm and think about this. We're all here to attend Hope Speak Academy, right? But we're living on an island like this instead. No matter what, it's completely weird.
Fiend.
Why don't you stop talking for a while? Go cool your head off or something.
Eh?
To tell you
plus, even if we wanted to leave, there's no way we can.
There's no ship and the planes are just a show.
It appears.
From what I've discovered, there's no way to contact the outside world either. In conclusion, it would be impossible to call for help. Then why don't we just swim home?
It's impossible!
There's no way we can swim that far!
Show some spirit!
Nekomaru,
yes we can!
What? Are you stupid?
I'm telling you that's impossible.
Then, what if you cut down some trees and made a raft?
I won't let you!
You can't do that! That's the biggest of no-nos!
Got it?
Please recall the guidelines of this school trip. Littering is not allowed. Let us coexist with this island's bountiful nature and mutual prosperity. Got it? I want everyone to get along and visit this beautiful tropical island.
Well, what's these rules? Who cares about that?
That's enough.
Stop! This rabbit seems to be rather finicky about these so-called rules. Based on that, what if your actions place everyone here in danger?
The word danger is a bit much. I wouldn't do something like that.
Hajime.
Hajime. I understand how you feel, but you need to calm down a little, okay?
For now.
As long as you don't do anything weird, it seems there is no danger.
Yep.
And as long as we gather hope fragments, we'll be able to get off this island soon.
You're all just gonna believe that.
There's no other choice but to believe. For now, that is.
Hey, hey!
Anyway, you saw me. What's this person you mentioned in your house from earlier?
Blah!
Oh, that's right. Well, of course I didn't forget.
My love!
This is it. Don't be upset. I prepared one for you, so don't worry.
What is this?
It's an Usami strap. If you squeeze the tummy, it talks.
I'm Usami, magical miracle girl Usami. I'm an itty bitty girl who's sweet like milk.
Eh?
Isn't it cute? Love, love.
What a waste of time.
Aww. Man, I got my hopes up too.
I'm ashamed. I even had my hopes up.
You think so?
Really? I think it's pretty cute. Especially after your ears look like a rabbit's. Well, Usami does mean rabbit, you know.
Regardless, a large number of Usami straps ended up on the beach anyway. As I figured, after everybody received their strap, they just tossed them on the beach.
Hey, you can't just take nature with trash. See, even you think they're trash.
Aww, poor Usami. Usami suddenly picked up the straps and looked at us with a lonely expression on her face.
I haven't prepared one more present too. But no, I don't want to give it to you bad kids. You have something else? Well, compared to the Usami strap, it's not that big of a deal. Basically, I prepared a motif for everyone.
A motive. Hey. Where we heard that before?
That's right. A motive for everyone to get along. We've come all this way to a tropical island, so I thought it'd be great to do something island themed. Like what? You figured to find a big party or something?
Ding ding ding!
Correct!
Wow!
Is it a festival? Maybe a miniature shrine? How wonderful!
Anyway.
Excuse me, Miss Sonia. My loins are still full of a poison, and I'd appreciate it if you could suck it out with your mouth.
Wait!
Knock it out, Teru.
Oh, your tenderloins? You betcha!
Just ignore him, Sonia.
I got it!
If we're talking about fun pies on Chuck Lavin, maybe it should be a barbecue or something. A campfire sounds fun too.
Let's kill!
Let's find a hoop snake and kill it!
Ugh.
You serious?
Just looking for what's not good enough for you.
I see.
It seems everyone has different ideas. But if we're gonna be at the ocean, then first.
Ta-da!
Ta-da! This is what it's all about.
This is.
A swimming bag.
Correct! Lovely!
Whoa!
Oh, then that means...
Ta-da!
That's right. I have swimsuits for everyone. Well, school swimsuits actually. I hope that's okay.
Are you telling us to go swimming in a situation like this?
Yes!
It's not like I'm ordering you guys to swim or anything. It's just if you want to go swimming, you can.
There's no way I'm going swimming. There's no way anyone would go so far, be so thoughtless as to go swimming in a situation like this. Of course, Ibuki. Eh?
That's right!
Oh yeah, that's what I'm talking about. Well, this and that's just no way I'm gonna pass in swimming. I agree. Even my loins agree, you see?
Your tender loins? I understand.
Wait!
Seriously, don't try to understand.
Hey!
How long has it been since I last saw him see?
Alright! Let's go change!
Most of us are excited to go swimming when to get their swimsuits from Usami. They ran straight to the hotel to change. Hey.
What are you gonna do, Hajime?
Hajime.
I understand how I feel. No one forced to do anything you don't want to do. If you feel up for it, I'd be happy if you came along too.
After he said that, Nagi to another hotel as well. There's no danger on this island. There's nothing tragic waiting to happen on this island. Is that really true? If so, am I actually wrong? Yeah, people that are excited at us, allow me to take a drink.
Ah, refreshing.
Okay. Let's see what everyone else here has got to say though. I assume these people here are not that bothered about swimming. You are not going to swim?
Nah, it's more fun to step on the crabs walking on the beach.
I see.
Say this, man.
So it looks like she's staying too. As unexpected. She seems like the more active type. Hey, you're not gonna swim?
Huh?
Of course I am. What?
Then why didn't you go with us to change?
So annoying.
I don't need to change. I gotta just take off my clothes.
No, what about your swimsuit?
You. It's not where I'm gonna wear something as embarrassing as a school swimsuit.
She's just wrong about so many things.
So let's hurry and swim.
Those words kind of quickly began taking off. Whoa, hey!
I won't forgive you.
Hey there, shameful behavior like that is a no-no. If you're going to swim, you've got to wear a swimsuit.
So annoying.
What a pain!
What a pain! Phew, phew.
Damn it! Why did you ruin our fan service?
Huh?
Oh, you're not going to swim, Hajime. How can I get you to believe me?
There's no way I can believe her.
Ah, speaking of which, everyone has returned.
As Usami said that, I turned around and I saw a group of people wearing swimsuits jumping into the ocean shouting with joy.
Yahoo!
Fan service!
Freaking made it in the middle, like, nyeh.
It's Gundam still wearing his scarf!
No. Well, here's everyone's happy. The
freaking Neku Maru, man. Them abs.
Jesus Christ.
Yay! The sea! The water is so cool. It feels great.
That's nice.
Too
salty! This water's too salty! It's not going easy on me!
Hey, I got some suntan lotion from the supermarket. Would anyone like a rub down?
What?
Come and let me put my hands on you.
Oh, you're quite considerate. Now then, will you apply it right away? Captain Cockblock is here!
Rubbing lotion on a muscular man. All right, no problem. My tastes are pretty open, you know.
Ah, Teru.
You seem a little too open. Like you're covering too many bases by yourself.
Well, someone's gotta cover them.
I'll make sure to slather you with lots and lots of oil.
What is this feeling of intense bloodlust? I'm gonna kill him.
Feels like a resort. There's no other way to describe it. Seeing a movie of students having all this fun,
I'm very happy. Everyone seems to be getting along with each other, so I'm very happy. I thought this would be hard as everyone got used to this, but we're acting like ultimates. Let's keep up the pace and all do our best to peace and enjoy this heart-throbbing school trip.
Huh. This feeling of alienation. Can't really put it into words. Am I really wrong about all this? Fine. Just gotta do it right. Then I'll do it! That's right. I'll do it! If it can neck him out, it's like, you do it!
Huh? Hajime, did something happen?
Hey, hand me one of those swimsuits. Jeez, I can't believe I was the only one worrying. I feel like an idiot. I don't care anymore, I'm gonna go for it. I'm gonna seriously enjoy myself and have fun.
Hey, you guys! Don't forget about me! Hey, wait for me! Let me join in the fun! Wait, huh?
Suddenly, the sky grew cloudy. Huh? What is this? What's happening? These strange clouds. This doesn't look natural at all. Hey, what's going on? What did you do? This is obviously not right. I'm sunny just a few minutes ago.
What is this?
Huh?
I didn't do anything. What is all this? There's no way something like this shouldn't be happening.
And at that exact moment, it doesn't seem like this couldn't get any more confusing. It suddenly happened. And it... It's gonna have to wait till next episode because I'm out of time for this one, so. Thanks so much for this, guys. I hope you enjoyed it. Remember to like, comment, subscribe, and I'll see you all in the next video.